G'day my lovely people, welcome yet again to my channel, Eleanor's Chronicles, and of course my name is Eleanor. My lovely people, let's get into today's skimsum episode, and this is my lighthearted take on what happened on today's episode. So, today's episode kicks off with Rathebe still having this tunya on Kanyago, when Babeile just comes right in time to save Kanyago's behind from Rathebe. Let me tell you something. Babeile's determination to uncover the truth is very commendable, but to be honest, his very serious demeanor on everything. Utala serious, lo baba lo. Could use a little bit of lightening up. Yazin atugut kanani man. Finally, things are going Babeile's way because now he's in the captain's good books, and his squad back at the station are going like, "Go Babeile, go." Because now he's got an upper hand on Rathebe, finally managing to arrest Rathebe and read those rights that he so long wanted to read to Rathebe. Just before going after Kanyago, who tried to make a run for it. While in the house, being Thandekile's house, we're still in Mpumalanga, guys. Stay with me. We have the two gone girls, Beng Thandekile, who is the wifey, and Thobakhale, who is the bride that was left. Should we say it's the altar? No, it was not at the altar. It was at some party, engagement party there. They are busy scratching each other's eyes out over who? Over Kanyago. And now Thandekile, no matter what anybody tries to say, is defending Kanyago, even when she's shown the proof that Kanyago has just paid over 2.3 million into Jacobeth's account from her money, mind you. Still, she's saying, "Oh, Amilo, forever yena, forever Kanyago." Mind you, this is not the only proof that this woman has. She also has her daughter's testimony telling her that, "Look here, I found proof that this man has known Luke, whom we know as Bernard, for over 2 years, and here's the photos that I found in Bernard's belongings." He has also overheard Kanyago threatening Thobakhale, yet assisted him to kidnap Thobakhale. Even furthermore, overheard again while Thobakhale was held captive and chained there, heard this husband of hers saying that yes, indeed, he did do what Thobakhale is accusing him of. But still, woman is still saying, "Forever yena, mina thanda yena, 2 million or not, I do not care. This is my husband, for better or worse, I said my vows." But then Babeile, being on the winning streak, finally managed to corner Kanyago, who had actually taken Jacobeth hostage and holding the situnya to her head. But then with the help of the gone girl, being Thandekile, who was able to calm down Kanyago and assure him that, "Look here, I don't care what these cops are saying. I don't care what this bitter toxic ex that you're holding hostage is saying, Mina, Mina tanda wena, and Mina will stand by your side. Let's go to the court. I promise you, my husband, I will use my millions to make sure you come back so that you can come back and scam me for real and run. Then Kanyaho gave himself up when he then saw that Thandekile is on his side, and therefore better than being on the run, it's better to just go and face the music, and hopefully Thandekile's millions will be able to free him. Then something annoying, something that just pissed me off happened. Babeile then arrested Thobakhale. For what? For being an accomplice to Kanyaho. And remember, I've been saying that what I see in this case is that Jacobeth is going to end up being an accomplice, and even this case, it might drag her down. You know, it's going to be hard for her to just get there and just set the story straight and get on with her life. That's not how it's gonna go. Not with over 2 million rand proof in her bank account. What's her proof that she was actually held hostage and people said she's a mad woman? Because the daughter can deny it in support of the mother. The mother is definitely gonna deny it in support of the forever Yena husband. That he's not willing to. He, you know, Thandekile says, "Ngimdala kangaka." So actually, that is the reason she does not want to lose Kanyaho, because she sees herself beautiful as she is, beautiful a queen as she is. She sees herself as old, as never going to find love if she can't stick to Kanyaho. Really? And that is what women do. That is what women do. That pisses me off so much, you know? Then back in Tafelkop, we see Elizabeth Thobakhale also putting her job in line after she just leaves without taking leave, because Mr. Khomo refused for her to take leave. Now she decided to leave and go after the mom because now she can feel it in her gut that her mom needs her right now. And the job, she doesn't care. She'd rather lose it. What she's going there, she's going to collect her mom and her husband, and nothing is going to stop her, not even a cyclone, for she is a cyclone in her own right. So she's headed over there, and we see Mantuli still very distraught over what is happening, and is feeling like the Maputlas are not taking her serious when she tells them that the boys are in danger. So, my lovely people, basically, these were the important pieces that happened in Skeem Saam for today. These are the important highlights that were there. Let's go down in the comment section. You tell me, what was your take on today's episode? I would really love to hear from you. Then till then, meet me in the next video. Remember, I love you.